This is a USA product built with pride in America. Pre-Donald Trump, nestled deep in the box, is an astounding tweeter. So miraculous.
Can I help?
Today I'm going to start some kick panel tweeter pods and sound skin the inside of the door panel and put the door panels back on.
I dropped it, just kidding. Look at it. So we need to make a tweeter ring, just kind of gonna figure out a spot for this thing to go up Russell's ass. No way, it's too nice. Up Russell's ass, you may ask yourself, ask.
So we need to find a place for this tweeter. Now you're supposed to keep your tweeter 6 inches away from the mid maximum. So everyone who's putting their tweeters up here, they're doing it wrong. So we need to keep this close to the mid. Kick panel tweeters are good because you could put them on axis, aim them at you, and the kick panels are more of an equal distance from the kick panel to your head versus from the defroster vent or pillar to your head. So I can just make a acrylic ring that this tweeter fits into, hole saw hole in the kick panel, glue the ring in at the perfect angle. Then we'll hit the edge with some Bondo glass. And repaint those panels.
It's Angel Dust, huh?
Amplifiers produced by Soundman Enterprises Inc., Mobile Solutions, and CT Sounds. This ring fits my tweeter perfectly. It's a nice tight fit, so it keeps the blood in my tweeter. Keeps it hard while Rafa's mom's riding it.
Awful, no, Rod. Dreadful. Terrible.
And it also fits my Macintosh tweeter quite well.
Labored. Bored. Painful.
Roger.
Do you need a set 65?
Humor.
I got my sense of humor. That was what my sense of humor.
That's why they call me Cock Ring Fitzwell.
Man,
what happened
to
your carpet?
Those
up,
it doesn't work.
Never gonna blow.
What? Ooh, we have a new coffee mug. Are you ready for this?
Look.
What could it be?
Look at this. Somebody come look at this. Look at this. Somebody come and look at this.
Oh, come on.
Look at this.
Oh, go figure. Look at that. Oh, look at that.
Got it for $700.
That's the most despicable thing I've ever seen. I love it. Thank you. What do we have here? Look.
What?
You know what today is?
This guy's like TJ Hunt, but with a car that's actually low. He's got a slam truck back there. It's like a little... If TJ Hunt was cool. These guys have a YouTube channel, YouTube slash
cars cuss words. I got some cool stickers.
Hell yeah. Thanks, guys.
Now I'm going to cut holes in the kick panels to fit the tweeter rings. Then I could sit in the car, find the perfect angle, and glue them in place.
Shoot, nice.
Perfectly even. And look. Look, I made a Star Wars mask.
Can I help you? Everyone's gonna argue tweeter placement till the end of time. Let me save you the hassle. This is the best way. Okay, I was born in a stereo shop. My mom shit me out in a speaker box. There's a reason Q-Logic kick panels sound good. Or you could be like Mark and put your tweeter 2 feet away from your mid. Off axis. Put a D-class amp on your highs. Time delay and EQ the shit out of it till it sounds like a mumbling robot like Mark's voice. His boxes don't even bump. Or you listen to me. And your shit can sound good. Or you could listen to the dude with the braids from Hackers.
Building a custom subwoofer box for a vehicle is really cool, and it can add a ton of sound to your car audio system.
Find legendary old school car audio gear at legendsofcaraudio.com.
Now I know the tweeters are going in the kick panels because I cut a giant hole. So I'll keep that tweeter wire in the door, but I'll cut it at the kick panel in case I ever need to run a wire back in the door. It's already in there. But first I may as well skin the inside of the door panels, put those back on.
Now I'm going to sound skin the inside of the door panel so I can put the door panels back on and listen for the perfect tweeter placement. If we listen for the tweeter placement before we put the door panel on, it'll sound different because we're gonna have some reflection of sound waves coming off the corner of the door panel. It's gonna cause a ripple effect through the fucking...
It's just too complicated. It's gonna cause a time delay in the off axis of the coordinate. God. If you just put the speaker in the right spot, it sounds good. You don't have to put...
You're gonna multiply it by how many cubic inches there are.
I have a very simple scientific philosophy when it comes to speaker placement. Put the shit in the right spot and it sounds good. What are you, fucking stupid?
Butt me!
What in the fuck? Someone glued Rafa's poncho back here. Let's see if I can save it so it doesn't rip. How did they get it? How did... Rafa's baby blanket.
Remove this rattly piece of shit. Rafa's pillow. Now look at what you did. Look at... Oh, it beats the game. The game beats itself. Getting rid of this old rattly foam and sound skinning the inside of the door panel is going to make a huge difference, and it will also improve Rafa's mood when he gets his childhood Ponchito back. The door is going to sound like a brand new BMW when you shut it. And that's also where Rafa got his Ponchito, from a big Mexican woman. Speaking of BMW.
What you need to do is shut up your mouth, alright? Shut your fucking whore mouth.
Damn.
That door slam sounds better than a brand new Rolls Royce. Salvaged one. I'm happy too because the passenger door wasn't shutting after that one time I three-wheeled it to test the hydraulics until I cut the roof out. Now it shuts. Driver's door doesn't shut though, so I three-wheeled it the other way. All the doors in the trunk popped open. You should have seen it.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
Now I can hook these tweeters up and see how good these babies sound. What if they don't even work? That Macintosh amp sounds good on those Macintosh speakers. That amp's rated 25 by 2. We have 25 by 2 on the highs and 150 watts on bass. That's a little baby system. Stupid good. It doesn't get so loud, but for that amount of power, it's crazy. I don't even understand how this can sound this good. It's impossible. That's 25 watts by 2.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
That's full range on the highs, too. There's no crossover in that amp.
That's less power than the OEM system that Mark at the Fab Kitchen pulled out of the car he's working on, but the system sounds better than the new system that he put in to replace.
What you need to do is shut your mouth, all right? Shut your fucking whore mouth, okay? You shut your fucking whore mouth.
I love you, Mark. I'm just giving you a hard time because you put your tweeters in the wrong spot. Thank you guys so much for watching. Leave a comment. Come back every Monday and Thursday at 7 a.m. Support Amplified by purchasing iPad dash kits and Soundman merch from soundmanca.com. Take your fabrication skills to the next level with the tools and trainings available from mobilesolutions-usa.com. Check upcoming training dates at mobilesolutions-usa.com/training. Go to ctsounds.com to get a discount on quality car stereo equipment with coupon code SOUNDMAN. See what kind of stereo system you could put together for your budget at ctsounds.com.